This is the full build for the Premium Bandai Master Grade Testament Gundam. Okay, I got all the pieces off the runners and cleaned up, so it's now time to get onto the build, so we'll just get right on into it. With this model, it starts with the chest and then kind of does the arms, then the waist and the legs, and then everything else, so we'll go right to the chest. Now, while taking everything apart, or taking all the pieces off and doing all the panel lining, I was trying to figure out what makes this premium, because there's not a whole lot of color separation. I think it's pretty accurate to what the anime is, but there are a few things like the weapons that are just fully gray and stuff like that. There's not a whole lot of, really tiny detail pieces. There's just a lot of big molded pieces and stuff like that. So I think what makes this premium is just they wanted to limit the number that they had to produce. So, but I still think it's going to be worth the build in the end. So that's all that's really important. Okay. I'm going to hold off on putting the pilot in until the end, because I want to make sure that this is accessible from after it's been put together, because I want to paint the pilot. And I've had many cases where once I put the pilot in, or I've had a couple of cases where once I put the pilot in, there's no way to get in there. And I didn't want to take the piece apart. So I'll wait until the end. It's not going to, either I can put it in or I don't. Doesn't really. Those are the two choices. Oh, this is multiple pieces. That's fine. Okay, so. Okay, this must be contributing to the articulation in the waist and the stomach crunch. There we go. Yeah. Now, one thing, this is a. I think this is what holds the backpack on. So this would be the back, I believe, because there's an option that if you were going to be using the IWSP backpack, which is separate, there's a black equivalent to this piece that you could use instead of the gray one. But since I'm not going to use that, I'm just going to use the gray one. Okay, so yeah, these are the arms attached, I'm assuming. That makes sense there. Get a little bit more articulation, it looks like. These are slightly angled. It probably would have been easier to put this piece on after putting the shoulders on. Oh, I see. Okay, that's cool. I see. Take out my square tweezer so I can press these into place. There we go. Fully see them. Almost opposite of what they seem to you think that they would. There we go. Okay. Much better. This overhangs the turn point here. That's how you know you have it on correctly. This one's seated down properly. There's a nub in the way, that's what's happening. Yes, we did it. A little millimeter of plastic. Okay. That's not crooked. I might have put the couple of little lines on one side. Looking at the picture of putting it together, it looks like I might have put this in backwards. But it shows the smooth part pointing out. Let's see if that improves anything. It's still crooked. Okay, that's better. Okay. That was an interesting way to put that on. Here we go. And this goes down and just holds that in place. There we go. Okay, that's okay. And these side skirt things. These little dimples here on the black piece here go in the front, or yeah, in front. Yes. goes in here first. I'm assuming that that's probably where the backpack, well, the weapon-ish type backpack thing that this has. There we go. What exactly is getting in the way here? We got this in there. One part of that hangs down a little bit lower. Now make sure that's pointing down. There's like a nub that has to go into this part here, but it's... difficult to see. Anyway.
Oh, there's that too. Huh. There's also a peg.
You think all these things would help everything line up perfectly. It's definitely closed there. So definitely all these things that have to connect in the back here that aren't quite doing what they're supposed to be doing. Just try this now. There we go. Okay. Finally. Yeah, there's a lot of little things that need to line up on this one to get everything seated in properly. Okay.
so. Yeah, it does. Okay. And then this holds all that in place. And, oh, well, good. There is a door able to get in there. That's interesting. Well, only one Vulcan on the chest. There's a place for another one, but it never was molded in. I mean, I think that's the way that the mobile suit is in the anime, but it's kind of an interesting. Okay, there is a door, so you'd be able to see the person in there. I just don't know if I'll be able to get them in there. Everything together. But I'll figure that out. If I have to take the chest apart to put them in, that's fine. That's interesting. Neat little detail here. There we go. There's the torso. Okay, cool. Now we'll do the head. Now this is the one place where a color correcting sticker is used, and it's for the eyes, which is fairly typical of just about any kit. On.
Now I'll go ahead and put these on since I have some help in positioning it with edges and stuff. Another bizarre thing to me, this was done in, this is a 2020 model, yet it has polycaps. I I would have thought that it would have been past the polycap stage for this. This is here. And then this is one. And then the top goes on this. And then this goes here. With this. Right there. Oops. I mean, there is some decent color separation. You know, there's some black here in the face and on the side, and there's the two tones of red. But you would think that with a premium Bandai Master Grade, there would be more. This is the very first one I've ever built, so I don't know what to really expect with these. It's a cool face. It's a cool head. Very elaborate headgear. Okay, that's it for the stickers. Okay, and on to the arms. Now, for the arms, basically everything is exactly the same, no matter which arm you're working on, until it comes to the hands. So there's not a lot to worry about on whether you're working on the left or the right arm. The instructions are all the same, like I said, until you get to the hands. And the hands are separate pieces. It's the typical kind of thing where they got the thumb articulation and then you've got the other four fingers doing the various grasping or trigger or open, things like that. Or fist even.
begin with. Okay, this must be elbow. Elbow joint. Okay, this is just so that the wrist can go into the ball joint. This goes like this. And clubs and just goes on here first, okay. That out of the way so all the stuff can go together. And this just goes over it. This. I guess the whatever the shoulder joint is going to hold that in place. This on here. Once again, doesn't matter because this can just turn either way. It'll happen to be that way. This is the right arm. I've designated it the right arm. Okay, I'll do the hand last. There's this whole shoulder to put together as well. I guess I'll take care of the hand now. Well, at least this uses the back of the hand to hold everything in place. Well, the thumb joint. And this right here is just the punching hand, you know, the fist hand, but it does have other hands as well, other fingers to manipulate with it. It's got a spread hand, a trigger finger, and a grasping, because this does have power sabers. Okay.
gotta kind of push it forward. So this is in the left arm. Oh, it doesn't have a, well, I guess it does. Just a strange way to do it. Oh, I just put them together in the same arms that are separate. And then this has the arm holds on the shoulder pads mechanism, but it looks like the peg is plenty long enough to keep everything on there, which is good, which is typical. The first one I did that had that type of attachment was the real grade RX-78-2, which was horrible. If you saw my build on that, you'll know how much fun I had on that one. Okay, we'll do the other arm now. Looks like I just put the wrong hands in the two, but doesn't really matter. I do have to say that I'm glad this isn't the first high grade, master grade that I built. I think I would have, been pretty disappointed. I may not have ever wanted to build another one. There's an L peg that fits into the slot. You just gotta get it arranged correctly. And I guess it's the same with any, with the high grade as well, which is your standard 1/40th or 1/44th, where you have various sizes and difficulty levels and everything like that. And this just happens to be that for the, the larger models. Nice little stack to know that it's in. There we go. There's the upper half. Okay. Do the waist now. This is definitely a quick build, not even a half an hour in. Oh, a little bit more. Okay. Oh, excuse me. A little bit of movement, not too much. Okay.
So.
Like there's something missing. There's this right here and then those for the side.
There we go.
There we are. Much better. I had this top part turned around. Now that fits perfectly. Okay. At least the inserts are the same. Another nub. There we go. Now, one thing that is that there are two gray ball joints and two black ones. So, as long as you're they're the exact same as far as fitting and all that kind of stuff. So as long as you're consistent on which one, what color you use, depending upon whether it's the front or the back, that's pretty much all that matters. Let's see here. These, the ones with the quarter circle on them are for the front. And the other ones are back. Now, an interesting thing to note is there are side skirts also, but they made those part of the leg construction, probably because it's just easier to put the leg on without the side skirts on. So, speaking about legs, we'll dive into that. And once again, it doesn't matter which leg you're putting together. The only thing that's different is the orientation of the hip joint. Everything else is exactly the same.
that's something they've got pretty well. Make sure this is seated down as far as it needs to go. It feels like it's not. Okay, much better. This is the foot. So that is the ankle joint, I'm assuming. There we go. Oh, I think that's the toe joint. Yeah. What is it?
missing. Basically just three pegs, one in the toe and two on the side, that it needs to get into. Okay, well, I guess we get some shading here. Oh, okay. This is different looking. Shin guard thing. Okay. It's the back shin guard. Oh, and there's the front one. Huh. That's different. There we go. Okay. There, nice and snug. Okay, this. It's into this groove right here. So that this can go on. Oops. Go. This right here. This looks like it's going to be a fairly intricate little mechanism here.
This was here. Okay. Let's just say it's out of the way. And this. Oh, I see. Okay, cool. Okay. It's here. That's where the anchor goes in. This goes like that because that's where the front ankle armor goes. We've got this. It just goes right on to there, it does. This. This brings everything together. Okay. that's cool. It's a neat mechanism. Okay, I'm... Wow, the armor attached to that must... Okay, cool. Okay. Is there... Okay, now I can say I'm impressed. Sides on first. Okay, and now let's... this.
bad. Yeah. Yeah, slide it up over the this piece over the ball joint. That's pretty cool. In the wrong section. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, a little bit tougher. The C-clip for this one's a little bit loose. Okay, have to be real careful with this foot. Okay. Okay, little pieces. I was able to fit that in just fine with the other leg. Okay. help that it's domed and slippery. Okay. So Alrighty. Seems like something should go there, but there wasn't anything to go there. I guess that's the back. I bet you... Oh. I put the legs on backwards. Because this is the front. Alrighty. Cool. It looks good. Actually, I'm glad I did use that new aluminum. Use the new aluminum panel liner on the black, and it really does kind of bring out the highlights on that. Okay, now for the weapons and accessories here. Excuse me. This is the Divine Striker. And the instructions here could be a little bit confusing because this has basically two mirror sides. And it shows here on the steps that you're going to do it twice, times two, but then one of the little inserts says times two. So really you're building four of these. You know, or four of these things that then go on to there. I believe.
single hand rifle. At least the maps are different. Okay. Okay. Got those two now. strange that it would be offset that much. Okay, I guess that's that. There's a ridge, though. I don't understand why. Without, don't go flush.
It does matter the side that you're working with. There's ridges on both sides of this here. There's ridges right there, and those ridges get recessed into these pieces here. Otherwise, it doesn't go together right. There we go. Boy, oh boy. Still is offset as far as these two pieces are concerned, unless... Okay, that's much better. Of course, the only reason I ran into that issue is I take the pieces off beforehand. But I figured it out. Knew something was wrong. There we go. It's just strange that those. I guess that way you can show the detail. Huh. Okay.
And that can slide up and down. Look at that. Not bad.
Okay. Well, it has a bit of a unique backpack. That's pretty cool. Okay, two pistols. Somewhat unique handles for the beam sabers. And then this Tricaris Kai. Oh, and these are all the extra hands, the extra fingers to go with the hands. There's both left and right for each of the different fingers. Oops. This one that is left and right for the spread hand as well, but maybe not. May just be buried underneath something. Nope, oh well. Okay, let's get this claw together. And there are three claws. Essentially, each claw has two pieces. There's some nibs in this that fit into those indents. It is pretty tight, so that's good. And then the claws go into this right here. Hopefully there's something that holds it in. Slide in from what appears to be the bottom.
that's this. Oh, yep, fits right in there. That's cool. This, yes, cool. And that's what holds in, yes. Yes. That's what holds them in, good. Very nice.
Turns out that was the top they slid in from, so I just gotta turn these around. There we are. Let's get them right the first time. So the gun isn't under the wrist. Right there. This is
There we go.
Well, that's it. That's the Testament Gundam built. Not bad. Neat little arm weapon. Couple of pistols. And a very cool backpack. Oops. Gonna probably have to glue these things on. Okay. Cool. Yep, those have to be glued on. Put those in there for right now. Cool. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you for the next one. Thank you for watching this video right to the end. If you did enjoy it, please do give it a thumbs up. That does help out the channel. If you would like notifications as to when new videos are posted to this channel, please do subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you do have time, please do enjoy one of the videos that are popping up around my head.